subscribe our channel, press the bell icon for latest videos.
Hi friends, here in this video, we are going to see a problem on flitch beam. For that, here is the question. Now, it is given a timber beam 20 cm wide and 30 cm deep. It means it is a wooden beam reinforced by a steel plate 20 cm wide and 1 cm thick bolted to its bottom edge. Means there is a timber beam and at the bottom of it a steel plate is bolted giving a composite beam 20 cm by 31 cm. That is the total cross sectional area of this beam. Calculate the maximum stress in steel and timber. So I'll write it in the data. We have to find out the maximum stress in steel, sigma suffix s, and wood or timber. When the composite beam is subjected to maximum bending moment of 60 kN meter, so capital M is given 60 kN meter, also called as the moment of resistance. So I'll convert it into Newton mm by multiplying it with 10^6. So this becomes directly Newton mm. That is 10^3 for this kilonewton to convert into Newton and 10^3 for meter to be converted into mm. 10^3 into 10^3 gives us 10^6. Now take E suffix S. Young's modulus of steel is 20 times of Young's modulus of wood. So therefore this 20 is nothing but the modular ratio which is given in the problem. Now whatever the cross section is given about the beam, that I'll draw it into the solution part. So let's get started with the solution. So this is a composite beam. Timber beam 20 cm wide. So the width is given as 20 cm, which I'll convert it into mm. It becomes 200 millimeters. And 30 cm deep. So that is the depth of timber given. 30 cm again into 10. That gives me 300 mm. So this is the cross section of timber or wood. Is reinforced by a steel plate 20 cm wide. So the width is same of wood and steel and 1 cm thick. So the thickness of the steel plate is 1 cm, which is the depth, that is 10 mm. Bolted at its bottom edge giving a composite beam of 20 cm by 31 cm. So this is 20 cm by 31 cm that I have completed. Now, whenever you have such a flitch beam, this beam which is given into the problem is symmetric about the y-axis. It is symmetric about y, but it is unsymmetric about x-axis because the steel plate is attached only at the bottom. If the same size of the steel plate would have been attached at the top, in that case it would have been a symmetric section. So whenever you encounter this in case of flitch beam where we have unsymmetric section, how to solve the problem, here I am giving a very important hint. You all can note it down that so the point is, whenever in flitch beams there is an unsymmetric section like we are seeing in this problem, then convert the given beam into an equivalent steel or wooden section throughout. It means for this beam, wood has to be replaced. In place of that, there can be steel throughout or steel can be replaced and we can have wood throughout. Now we can solve the problem by using either of the two ways. In this problem, I am going to be converting this into an equivalent steel problem by replacing wood. So I have to find out the width of steel required in order to replace the wooden section. So I can say that since the width of steel upon the width of wood is equal to the modular ratio, that is, it is 1 upon modular ratio, which is stress in steel, and here we have stress in wood. It means width is inversely proportional to stress, and this is also equal to the Young's modulus ratio. And for this concept, you all can refer my previous video in which I had explained the concept of flitch beam. There you can find this formula. Now, as the modular ratio is given as 20, EW by ES is 1 upon 20, because ES by EW is 20. So therefore, the width of steel required would be, the timber it is having width of 200, and here it is 1 by 20. So width of steel required will be 200 divided by 20, and it gives me the value as 10. So this is the width of steel which is required. Now here I would be replacing the wood having width 200. In place of that, there will be steel having width 10 mm. So drawing an equivalent diagram just adjacent to it, the given beam. So here into this diagram, wood has been replaced with steel throughout. So this is an equivalent steel section. You can also convert this into a wooden section. In that case, wood will remain as it is, steel would be replaced. And how to calculate the width of wood? You can use the same concept, same formula, and you are going to find the width of wood by replacing steel. Here I have converted it into an equivalent steel column. Now, once I have converted this, again it is symmetric about Y. And X axis we don't know. For X axis we need Y bar. For that purpose, I am dividing it into two area. This is area first and this is area second. Now I am going to calculate Y bar. So, taking all the references from bottom, Y bar is A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 upon A1 plus A2. That will be the first equation. Therefore, area 1 is, here the width is 200 and the height is 10. So it is 200 into 10. 2000 mm square. Y1 is the distance of the x axis for the first rectangle from the origin. This is the origin. From here, the distance of x axis is half of 10, that is Y1, so it is 5. Next, area 2 is, this is having, this portion is having width of 10. So 10 into 300, it is 3000 mm square, and Y2 is the location of x axis for the second rectangle. Now second rectangle is over here, its y axis will pass through half of 300, but since we are taking the distances from bottom, we have to add 10 mm, that is 10 plus half of 150. Half of 300, it means it is 150. So 150 plus 10, that will be Y2. So it is 10 plus half of 300, that is 160 millimeters. So putting all values in equation 1, we'll get the answer of y bar. Area 1 into y1 plus area 2 into y2 upon area 1 plus area 2. So I am getting the answer of y bar. It comes out to be 98 mm from bottom. And why from bottom? Because the references which we have taken, they are from bottom. So we have located the x-axis from bottom. Similarly, from top, for that I require the total distance, which is 310 mm. So therefore y bar will be 310 minus 98 mm. So it comes out to be 212 mm from top. Now once we know the y bar, we can locate the x axis, and since y2 is 160 and from bottom y bar is 98, it means it is below this 160 value. So somewhere here it should be the y bar, which is 98 mm. So from the top it is 212 mm. And once this x-axis have been located, this is the neutral axis. And now I need to find out the moment of inertia about this neutral axis. For that, I am going to use the parallel axis theorem. Now, since MI, or moment of inertia about the neutral axis, is given by Ixx is equal to Ixx1 plus Ixx2, and this is equation 2, and therefore Ixx1 will be I1 plus area 1 into H1 square. This is by parallel axis theorem. So here, why I had used parallel axis theorem, the reason for it being that the x-axis for rectangle 1 is at y1 distance, but the x-axis for the complete cross section is at 98 mm. So in between them the distance is there, which is called as h1. That is why we have to use parallel axis theorem. And i1 is the moment of inertia about its own axis, that is for rectangle 1 about its own x-axis, and it is BD cube by 12. So I1 is BD cube by 12, area 1 is B into D, H1 is the distance between the two axes, that is 98 minus this 5 will give me H1 value. So 98 minus 5, which is half of 10, B and D values for the section, B is 200, D is 10. So it is 200 into 10 cube divided by 12 plus B into D, that area is 2000, and then it is 98 minus 5 whole square. So from this I am getting the answer of Ixx1, and it comes out to be, it is 17.31 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Now similarly I will be calculating Ixx2. So Ixx2 will be I2 plus area 2 into H2 square, and that is also by parallel axis theorem. And again I2 is the moment of inertia for rectangle 2 about its own x-axis, that is BD cube by 12, area is B into D. Now H2 is the distance between the x-axis of rectangle 2, which is at 160 mm from bottom, and here it is 160 from bottom, and at the same time the x-axis for the complete system is at 98 mm. or we can say from the top it is 212 mm, and from that if I subtract this value, which is again 150, will give me the distance between the two axes of rectangle 2 and the complete system, which is h2. So h2 is 212 minus 150. So 212 minus 150 is half of 300. Then B and D. B is 10, D is 300. So 10 into 300 cube divided by 12, and your B into D, the area is 3000. So it is finally coming out to be IX62 value, which is 34.03 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. Now putting IXX1 and IXX2 in equation second to get IXX. So put all values in equation second. So from this I am going to get the answer of IXX, which is the addition of these two values, and it comes out to be 51.34 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4, and this would be the I value which I am going to use in the further part of the problem. Now once I value is known, the question is we have to find the maximum stress in steel and timber. So when I look into this diagram, steel is there at the bottom at 98 mm distance. First I'll get the value of stress over this 98 mm. For that I'll be using the flexural formula, that since from the flexural formula which says that M upon I is equal to sigma B upon Y, and since we are using it specifically for the material steel, so M, I will go on to other side, I suffix S upon YS into sigma S. Now in order to get the maximum value, I'll have to put the maximum distance, that is 98 mm where steel is present, because when we take 212 mm at this location, steel is not there into the original diagram. Steel is there at the bottom, and the more distance we take, there will be more value of stress. So it is 98 mm and not 212, because in the original diagram at top steel is not there, it is there at the bottom. So 98 mm, putting the values, M is given in the question, 60 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. I of steel, that is the complete section answer which I have got just now, Y is 98. So therefore the stress in steel, which is maximum, and the answer is 114.53 newton per mm square. So this is the maximum stress in steel. Now I would be calculating the maximum stress in wood for that. Similarly, see, first I'll get the maximum stress in the equivalent section of steel, because at 212 in the equivalent section there is steel, and then I'll get the value for wood. So for that, similarly I'm using the formula, M upon I is equal to I suffix S, then sigma S YS. So therefore M will become I suffix S upon YS into sigma S. Now moment is 60 into 10 raised to 6. I of steel is same, 51.34 10 raised to 6. Now next, Y of steel is 212, and therefore the maximum stress of steel at 212, the answer comes out to be 247.76 newton per mm square. Now this is not the value of steel which is there originally, because at 1212 mm this steel was there in the equivalent diagram, but in the original diagram we have wood here. So the answer which we are getting of steel, I am going to divide it by the modular ratio to get the maximum stress in wood. So for that, therefore the maximum stress in steel would be divided by the modular ratio to get the maximum stress in wood. And why this relation? Since M is sigma S upon sigma W. So therefore 247.76 divided by M, which is 20, given So from that I am going to get the value, and it comes out to be the maximum stress in wood is 12.39 Newton per mm square. So this is the second answer, means I have calculated the maximum stress in steel at the bottom and wood at the top. Now I would also be calculating the stress at this interface where steel and wood, they are meeting. So therefore, for that calculation of stress at the interface, and for that I can use the concept, that is, I'm going to draw the stress distribution diagram for the steel section. This is the stress distribution for steel. At bottom, the stress was, it was 114.53, and at top, the stress in steel came out to be 247.76. And the stress goes on increasing the more we increase the distance from the neutral axis. Now I am going to calculate the stress at this interface. So I am denoting this stress as sigma s dash. For that I can use the concept of two similar triangles. Like here the triangle is having base sigma s dash, this is having the base 114.53, and their heights are also different. Like bigger triangle is having height 98, and this smaller triangle would be having a height 98 minus 10, that is 88 mm. So at the interface I am going to find the stress. So sigma s dash upon sigma s is equal to their respective distances in the numerator. Sigma s dash is located at 88 mm, sigma s at 98 mm. So 88 upon 98, therefore sigma s dash, and the value of steel at the bottom is 114.53, which is sigma s value, into 88 divided by 98. So therefore sigma s dash at the interface, it comes out to be 102.84 Newton per mm square, and this value will obviously be less than the maximum value at the bottom, which is 114.53. Similarly, I can also calculate the value of wood at this interface, because at the interface there is steel as well as wood, and this figure which I have drawn, it is stress distribution diagram for steel. Similarly for wood, I'll just have to divide this stress at the interface by modular ratio. So therefore the stress in wood at the interface is sigma w dash, which is sigma s dash divided by the modular ratio, 102.84 divided by 20, and the answer at the interface stress in wood comes out to be 5.14 Newton per mm square. So this is the complete solution to the problem. And here in this video we have seen how to find the stresses in case of flitched beams. This was the first problem, and with this the problem gets completed.